Right, YouTube, in this video what we are going to see is how to insert data using AngularJS. As you can see on the screen, we have two input field, country code and country. If we insert these two input field, the data will be inserted into the database called test. Inside the test, we have a table called country. Inside the country, we have two columns, which is ID and name. These ID is a code and the name is a country name. Fine, let me show you the HTML for it. Before that HTML, we need two CDNs. For this project, we need two CDN. The first CDN is for Bootstrap. It is optional if you are using only Angular. The second CDN is for the AngularJS. You can get the AngularJS CDN in W3 School or in the Google. Fine. Before that, let's start the AngularJS project right now. If we want to start AngularJS project, we would need a div, and this div would have a ng-app element, or in Angular word we call it directive, and we need a controller. What this controller will do is whatever text field inside it, we can access the text field with the help of controller. So if you want to access this text field, this text field's data, ng-model will help you. Similarly for this, we have another ng-model. And when I click on it, we have a directive called ng-click. This function will fetch the data from the controller and display it into the database. Let me start the AngularJS project from scratch. Fine, before doing anything, you need to create a object of angular.module. The first one would be the div where the Angular starts, AngularJS starts. And second one would be the array. And now with the help of object, call the controller function, and this controller will have the controller name. The controller name here is user controller, and the second one is simply the function. Properly comment the data or else you will be in problem. Now this controller, we have two parameter. The first one is scope, the second one is HTTP. HTTP will be used to send the data to another page, will act as a AJAX if you know jQuery. The second one is scope, which will allow you to access the text field inside the controller. If you know AJAX, this code will be very easy for you. I would strongly recommend to learn AJAX before doing AngularJS. The syntax is changed. Everything else is similar. Now when I click on the button, the function will get executed. So this function, I'm going to define it with the help of in the AngularJS. So with the, now I'm going to send the data to another PHP file. So how we are going to do? $http.post round bracket. On the first parameter, it would be the page insert.php. The second one would be the data we are going to send. The first one is ID. The second one would be name. And you know the ng model, first ng model, we are going to access it with the help of scope dot, and the second data ng model, we are going to access it with the help of dollar scope. data received with the help of scope, and we are sending it as ID and name. Let me keep it as names. Fine. Now these are done. Now it's time for another function, which HTTPS success. If you know AJAX, this is really very similar to AJAX success function. We will get the data from the insert.php in the parameter of function, and once the data is submitted, I want the alert which will display either the data is submitted or not submitted. And then these two text field will have the value null once I click on submit. This is similar to the jQuery we would be using. In jQuery we would be using the ID. Now we are using the ng model directive. That's the only difference. Everything else is similar, including the syntax for AJAX. Now it's time for the insert.php. We have completed the AngularJS part. Once I click on the submit, what you will do is the data will be passed to the insert.php, and in the insert.php the database connection is established, and this is new in Angular. What this function will do is, this function is from PHP. What this function will do is it will fetch all the data received from the input field, and once the data is fetched from the input field, we are converting it to the JSON. When we convert it to the JSON, we will get the associative array as an input. With the help of associative array, we can take our ID and names which we have sent with the help of AJAX, sorry, with the help of AngularJS. We have received it from the variable data, and we are saving it to a variable called ID received and names received. And this function is really important to prevent SQL injection. Now we are running a query which will insert value in the table country, and the column which will be affected is the ID and the names, and the value which we have received from the variable data and stored it into a variable. Fine. Once the query runs successfully, if there is an error, it will say error. If there is not error, it will say data inserted. Let me refresh the page and check. Now it's time for the country code 81, which is for China. Add data inserted. That means our query has executed properly without any error. Don't worry about the source code, you will get the source code in the description along with the database backup. Let me show. Yes, it has properly updated. Thank you so much for listening.